They're not undefeated. The Philadelphia Eagles are undefeated. Now, I understand what Kimberly is saying.
I'm with Key
on
that.
No, look at who they played. Look at who they played. Look at who the Eagles started the season beating.
You are what your record
says you are.
Oh, stop.
Just beat the Cowboys. They just beat the Cowboys.
Played the Bills. With Cooper Rush. That the Eagles would beat the Bills.
Beat everyone else.
You think the Eagles playing the Bills, you see the Eagles beating the Bills.
I also thought that the Bills played Kansas City, that Kansas City would beat the Bills. It didn't happen.
That's my point.
But that doesn't mean that Kansas City's not a better football team than Buffalo.
Kimberly, just, if they're both healthy.
Time, it didn't happen.
If they're,
what I was going to say, why, is what are the two strengths on the Buffalo Bills? Their receivers, right? Diggs and Davis. How about the DBs in Philadelphia? So when you match that up, it might be a little different than what most people think. This is not Pittsburgh. This is not Tennessee. This is not the secondary of a backup rookies in Kansas City.
I got you.
That's all I'm saying.
I got you.
That's why I'm
not
Before
you get to the wide receivers, you would say Josh Allen is the reason.
Jalen Hurts is a pocket Josh Allen, basically. He's like a pocket-sized Josh Allen.
Can I say something? Josh Allen's MVP right now, man.
I agree. At this moment, he is. Yeah.
His size and his frame is different than Jalen Hurts.
At this moment, Josh Allen
is different than Jalen Hurts.
And not only that.
I think Jalen Hurts is having an MVP type of season, but the quarterbacks are very different.
It's like he's a pocket size.
There's levels between Josh Allen and Jalen Hurts.
This is what I'll say about Josh Allen. Josh Allen, to me.
Bradbury and Darius, and not Darius Slay.
Slay.
At the cornerback spot.
Yep.
That's going to be a tough out. That's all I'm saying. It's a tough out.
Kimberly, if both teams are healthy, who's better on the line of scrimmage, Eagles or Bills? Both sides of the line of scrimmage.
Eagles
are probably better on both sides of the line of scrimmage.
Who runs the ball better?
Well, running the ball has been the issue for the Bills.
That's all I'm saying.
I'm saying the quarterback play. Like
Josh Allen's a legend. He's going to be a legend in the game. He will be a legend in the game.
Josh Allen, he is inevitable. He's like Thanos. Like when him and Patrick Mahomes, he's reached that level of like, hey, when he gets the ball, they're probably going to score.
And don't
you
let the
can't
Bills,
say that about a lot of teams.
Don't let the Bills pull the trigger on CMC.
Don't
let them pull Christian McCaffrey.
If they got Christian McCaffrey,
you talk about
a
run game, you add
a
piece like that.
It's a different situation when they get if in fact they get Christian McCaffrey. But the San Francisco 49ers aren't going away on that one either.
That's true.
Yeah. Josh Allen looks to me like he is going to be a great Hall of Fame quarterback at this moment, right? Like it feels like he's arrived in a different way by beating Mahomes.
Twice in a regular season, right, James?
Yeah. But listen.
He is on one today.
Mahomes is already in. Who's not? Kimberly A. Martin, ESPN NFL reporter extraordinaire. First Take Her Take podcast. Is on set with us. Play real or not real. Kimberly, where are we on the Jordan 3s? I think the Jordan 3s of every sneaker that ever dropped, Jay, I don't know if you were around for this or if you were, but we were around for this. When the Jordan 3s first dropped, I was like, it's the best looking thing I've ever seen in my life.
Yeah, they look fly, though.
They're the most comfy Jays.
Yeah.
The only thing is they crease in the middle. You see, Kimberly's worn those once. Because there's no crease in the top.
You know what? My followers get on me about, the creases. You got to live in your shoes. That's how I feel. I bought them. I'm aware. I'm not stressed about the creases.
I swear
as much.
She got about 10,000 pairs of shoes.
No question.
But that's you got to rock them. You can't let them sit in the box
for five years. What's the point? I'm not DJ Khaled. Like, I don't have 4,000 pairs that could just.
God did.
Maybe 3,000. All right. Kimberly, are you ready to play real or not real?
I am.
Born ready. All right. The Cowboys need Dak Prescott, real or not real?
It's real. But can I just say, do we need to rush him back against the Lions? Do we need to? I don't know. They do need him for the rest of the season. Like, you need to have your QB in there because you need to – this offense, this isn't the same offense that played the Bucs. This isn't the same team that played the Bucs in week one. Dak has to get out there, get more comfortable. I just want to make sure that he's 100% ready, like without a doubt, because if he has a setback, I think it's over.
It's certainly real. And we're talking about a hand. We're not talking about a shoulder or ankle or knee. So the setback would be if they get underneath the center, if they hit his hand too hard with the ball and it does something, or if somebody he's going to throw it, it hits a helmet or it hits a hand like Carson Wentz. Outside of that, I think he needs to get back in the rhythm.
In the rhythm of it?
Yeah, he needs to get back in the rhythm. You got the Lions, which – we all assume you don't really need him against the Lions.
They're feisty, man.
But we also saw Mr. Rush turn back into a pumpkin against the Eagles?
I'll say it's real, and to answer your question, Kim, I mean, if you look at the roster, the season, the schedule, is there a better time? I mean, versus the Lions and the Bears? I know the Lions are
Lions,
feisty,
Bears,
but
and
Lions,
the bye.
Bears, then the bye, and, well, then you got the Packers, actually.
That's why you need him back. Yeah. Get in the rhythm.
Get in rhythm before you have to face the Packers.
That's a great question. Kimberly, you talked me into it, and then I think he talked me out of it. But it's true. They do need Dak to beat the elite teams, right? Yeah. That's what we just saw with Cooper Rush.
Right.
But if you want Dak, maybe with what you just said, Key, they can buy him enough time right now to be totally good after the bye.
I don't want to stay on Dak because we got other things to move on, but just think of it this way, fellas, and I hate to do this because I played the NFL every single game, no matter.
If you guys didn't know, he was the best receiver ever to play in the NFL.
Yeah, that's true. At least you know. But what I would say is, I don't want to treat this like a preseason. But
said that there's merit to remove Dan Snyder as owner. This is a big thing for another owner to come out and say this about a fellow owner. Listen to Jim Irsay.
I believe that there's merit to remove him as owner of the Redskins. Some of the things I've heard, it doesn't represent us at all. And, you know, I want the American public and the world to know what we're about as owners. I believe it's in the best interest of the National Football League that we look it squarely in the eye and deal with it.
Well, at least get the name of the team.
The
right.
Commanders. It'd be nice. He's already been removed as owner of that other team because now they're called the Commanders.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you know, it's probably stuck in his mind that they were the team of the past.
Can I just tell you how much I love this? This is reminiscent of my favorite show, House of Cards. I mean, this is like billionaires, political geniuses that have so much. Not anymore.
I watched it through half of it.
I don't
want to
get into it right now. We'll leave that alone for another day. But like the fact that for a removal of an owner, you need 3/4 approval of all the owners in the league, and then for Dan Snyder to kind of retaliate by saying that, or people coming to the conclusion that he has a lot of stuff on other owners. Like, just watching how this dance has to happen, Key, in real time, and understanding relationships, it leaves me frazzled. I don't even know what to think about
you
it.
You need 24, so 3/4 is 24 out of 32. 24.
I was going to say 24 out of 32. Just let Jay say
3/4. Yeah, same thing. Yeah.
So they need, same thing, but I'm just saying, they need 24 votes, and for him to say that, for Jim Irsay, owner of the Colts, to say that, maybe he, you know, like
rally cry.
Or do you think, we got the 24.
Rally cry, what do you mean by that?
I'm letting other owners know who may not like what's going on. I'm going to take a stand on it. Let's see who's with me.
Oh, no, the other owners are already with him.
Or he wouldn't have said it, right?
Saying anything.
Or that he wouldn't have said that, right?
Oh, my God, yes. You go ahead and handle it, Jim. Just you deal with it right now. And we'll.
So this is a bad sign for Dan Snyder.
They'll get the 24. They'll get the 24. And he'll be out. He'll fight it. He's got a few billion. He'll spend a few whatever it costs to fight it. You're not just going to take his team. They're not going to just allow you to take the team. But 24 owners are going to side with or there's going to be 24 owners that get together and say this is enough for our league, because what it happens is it starts to affect the view of the league as a whole. You can't have that. The shield gets affected. Therefore, once that gets affected, it jeopardizes what? The bottom line. If it jeopardizes the bottom line, we can't have that. You know how it goes.
That all makes sense. Do you think that this public statement by Irsay is in any way a reaction to the report that Dan Snyder says he has dirt on owners? And so now the owners are sending one of their guys out to be like, we're not playing that way. Now we're serious about taking you out.
They're not. It probably has something to do with it to a small degree, but they've already decided a while ago that they probably was going to go 24 votes to get him out a while ago, but they've yet to arrive to it because there's technicalities and things that they have to do because they don't want to get sued. So everything's got to be
ducks
all the
in
boxes
a row.
Got to be checked and ducks got to be in a row. He just stepped out in front to let him know, we're going to push back on you, bro. So you running your mouth and saying you got stuff on other owners, you know, Jerry Jones is friends of such and such, and this guy and Mr. Kraft is friends of him, and the Rooney family is friends of his, And they all know that right now he's a bad guy for us in our business.
Good for Jim Irsay, though. Good for him to speak up on what where we want the NFL to be. Like, what do we always talk about with the NFL as it relates to accountability, right? When things happen, things naturally get swept under the rug. Everybody's life moves on. People don't forget about it. They bring it up. But the NFL is such a juggernaut that business continues to go on.
Now,
good for Jim Irsay to come up and say something.
I agree. It's stunning in a way, but in another way, you're grateful that an owner has said something. Does Irsay's let's listen to the commissioner. Roger Goodell was asked about Irsay making that